Chinese smartphone maker Coolpad has been quite active in the sub 10,000 rupee segment with its Note series of smartphones. Now with its eyes set on the 15,000 rupee segment, Coolpad has launched a new device called the CoolPlay 6. Priced at 14,999 and exclusively available on Amazon, is this smartphone your best bet? Well, we find out.
One look at the CoolPlay 6 and it is safe to say that the front reminds us of the Lee Eco LE2. The earpiece, selfie camera and sensor placement are all identical. With the screen off, it does look like the phone has an edge-to-edge panel, but there's actually a thin black border around it. The CoolPlay 6 has a 5.5-inch Full HD display and capacitive touch buttons below it. They are backlit but stay on only for 5 seconds when the screen is powered on. This defeats the purpose and we couldn't find a way to change this behavior. The CoolPlay 6 has a metal panel at the back with plastic caps at the top and bottom. There are dual rear cameras with a dual tone LED flash. The camera bump is protected by a raised metal edge around it. Below it is the fingerprint scanner which has a mirror finish. The back curves around the sides and Coolpad has also curved the edges which makes this phone comfortable to hold. The power and volume buttons on the smartphone are placed a little too high and we had to stretch to reach them. There's a USB Type-C port at the bottom with grills on either side, though only the one on the right is a speaker. Smartphones in the sub 15,000 rupee market are now quite powerful and the CoolPlay 6 is a good example. The smartphone is powered by a Snapdragon 653 SoC, an octa-core processor with 4 cores clocked at 1.95 GHz and the other 4 cores clocked at 1.44 GHz. There is 6GB of RAM and 64GB of storage, making this one of the best spec devices at this price. Storage isn't expandable, but at 64GB, we aren't complaining. The CoolPlay 6 is a dual SIM device with 2 nano SIM slots and it supports 4G as well as VoLTE on both. It has a non-removable 4000mAh battery and you get a 10W charger in the box. It runs on Android Nougat and Coolpad seems to have updated its Cool UI and rebranded it to Journey UI. It is closer to stock Android than before. There is theme support but we found only 2 themes to choose from with no way of adding or installing more. One annoyance with the new UI is that notifications cannot be swiped away easily. You need to tap a delete button after swiping, making it a 2-step process. You do get a tiny shortcut at the bottom to dismiss all notifications in one go. The fingerprint scanner is very accurate and fast. Journey UI has dual app support which lets you run 2 instances of WhatsApp, Twitter and more. Overall, the UI is easy to use except for the annoying bit about notifications. The 6GB RAM on the spec sheet is helpful when you're multitasking between multiple applications. We could switch between a few games without any hint of lag or stutter. With our usage, we found the device to have over 3GB of RAM free over a day of use. We faced no issues when gaming either. This phone is powerful and can run most games without any issues. It does get warm after gaming for a long time, but it isn't uncomfortable. Battery performance is good and the device does manage to go beyond one day with light to medium use. Coolpad has put in battery saver modes and you also have the option of forcing apps to hibernate after the screen switches off to save power. While the big battery is nice to have, charging takes close to 2 hours with the supplied 10W charger. For photography, the CoolPlay 6 is equipped with dual 13MP cameras, one with an RGB sensor and the other with a monochrome sensor. At the front, there is an 8MP camera. The camera app offers a range of modes to choose from, including panorama, GIF, monochrome photo and video, and an SLR mode for bokeh. The second sensor is used for monochrome mode and for measuring depth in SLR mode. You also get Pro mode, which gives you more control over the camera settings. Photos taken with the CoolPlay 6 turned out to be average. Larger objects did have some amount of detail, but we generally saw a loss of quality in most photos. We also noticed purple fringing when shooting against the light. Taking macros can get tedious as the device had a hard time focusing on what we wanted. But when it did manage to focus, the details were good. Photos taken in low light with the night mode enabled had a considerable amount of noise and artifacting. Selfies are decent enough to be shared on social media, but you will need to have a steady hand. The CoolPlay 6's rear camera are capable of 4K video recording at 30fps and the front one tops out at 1080p. We captured 4K video for over 10 minutes and while the phone didn't get warm, it wasn't uncomfortable to hold. 4K video recording stops near the 13 second mark with a message on the screen stating that the file size upper limit has been reached. From the looks of it, the CoolPad CoolPlay 6 is a performance focused device. The Snapdragon 653 SoC along with 6GB of RAM means that this phone can pretty much brute force its way through anything you throw at it. Also, there's more internal storage than other smartphones at this price point. With Journey UI, Coolpad has brought the user experience closer to stock Android than before. However, camera performance is strictly average and the wait to top the battery up can be annoying. If you are in the market for a powerful smartphone on a budget, then it is safe to say that your search can end with the Coolpad Coolplay 6.
But if you need a versatile performer with a good camera, you should keep looking. Thanks for watching. Do hit the like button and don't forget to subscribe. You can also follow us on Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram at Gadgets360.